We will not be blowing up anything in this year's, but we have, once we set these scenes up, the students are allowed to see them. These students are divided into groups, and these groups compete with each other to solve the crime. Now, along the way, it's not all just solving the crime or visiting the crime scene. They do that early on. They have breakout sessions where it's many lectures on DNA, on gunshot residue, on fingerprints, blood pattern analysis, and on and on. I don't give them that much information. They have to tell me what they want. Critical thinking is a big part of this. Each group has a computer with a thumb drive. And the only thing I'll give them to start off is a call to a dispatcher. And that's it. Mm-hmm. And then I ask them, it'll be someone saying that they saw a body or heard a gunshot or whatever. And that's all I give them. And the groups have to decide. So teamwork is another thing that involved with this. The kids have to decide, what's the first question we could ask? And usually it's, what did the first officer on the crime scene see? And when they come and ask me that question, I take their thumb drive, plug it into my computer, and just give them the copy of that officer's report. That report may have the neighbor's name, other people's name in that. And as they begin to do this, they'll ask for interviews for different people. And depending on who they ask for, they go in different directions. And I have red herrings in there. I can take them down the wrong trail for a while. And ultimately, they visited the crime scene. They have to ask for, do you have a fingerprint report or a blood pattern report or any type of trace evidence report, ballistics, you name it.